Math Bubbles is an exploration that reinforces counting, one-to-one correspondence, sorting by attribute, number sense, number composition, division, and currency. Settings. The settings screen of this exploration is loaded with options. Let's go over the basics. Bubble machine on and off. We'll start with it on. Ambient sounds on and off. This can allow for quieter play if you turn it off. We'll leave it on. Division mode. We'll touch on that later. Theme. Use these buttons to select which tokens will appear on the screen. We'll start with critters. Token selection happens with these sliders. I'm going to start with 5 of each critter. The first thing you should notice is that it isn't obvious what you should do with this exploration. Math Bubbles is an open-ended exploration. Watch as I turn the bubble machine. It creates more bubbles and the bubble solution reduces. When all solution is gone, the bubble machine will disappear. Watch as I place the 5 bees into a bubble. The bubble counts them. This is one-to-one correspondence. What if I try to put a dog into the bubble with the bees? It lets me combine the critters. Watch what happens when I move a bubble over the critters. It will capture them. Can I join 2 bubbles together? How about pull one apart? Be careful not to have your finger on a critter when you do this, or you will remove the critter rather than splitting the bubble. If I put the bubble back together and pull it apart again, I should get a different result. The decomposing of the number is random. There are many surprises built into Math Bubbles. Penelope is one of my favorites. She came along because the children wanted to pop the bubbles when we were in development. However, the natural popping action was the same gesture that the children would use to touch the critters as they were counting. So, Penelope was born. When children first discover her, and please let them do this on their own, it is a blast. Penelope also has an integral part of the character education portion of interacting with peers on the technology devices. Just like any other learning center, there are rules and expectations, and children must respect their friends. Let's return to the Settings tab and we'll make a few changes. I'll turn the bubble machine off, we'll switch to money, and reset my tokens. Use the top bar to slide everything to 0 and then choose your tokens. You'll notice that the bubble machine is now off screen and creates 2 bubbles at the start of play. If you want more bubbles, you can divide like this. This mode uses all the same physics as with critters, but counts currency instead. You can tap the coins and dollars to flip them. You'll notice that I captured Penelope in a bubble. This can be accomplished by floating a bubble over her. Again, I can join all the bubbles together, and when I do, a fresh bubble appears. I can pull them apart and allow Penelope to escape, and then pop. Finally, let's explore division mode. I return to settings by swiping up from the bottom of the screen to get to the menu screen. I'll use construction workers this time. Let's turn the bubble machine on. Let's turn division mode on. A slider appears that allows me to select the divisor. Let's use 4. Now let's select the tokens. To start, I'm going to work in multiples of 4. I'm going to place all of my workers into one bubble, but leave Penelope, who is holding the divisor, on the outside. When Penelope pops a bubble in division mode, she will divide the bubble into as many bubbles as the divisor she is holding. In this case, the number 4. I now have 4 groups of 6. Let's look at how Penelope handles remainders. If I pop a bubble with 9, I will get 4 groups of 2, with a remainder of 1. The remainder of 1 will float outside of the bubbles. It is best to keep the number of tokens lower for this exploration until the children become more familiar with how the numbers behave. Swipe up to return to the main screen, and then swipe down from the top to the bottom to close the exploration.